Genesis, we find God taking the mud and giving his own breath to man. That man may have short breath, but not death breath until he wishes. This short breath is like a wave. When it is over, again, the God inside will give another breath, another breath, another breath, another breath, that you may meet him. I was told there was a man who was told that there is a beautiful town which was built on a beautiful temple which was once upon a time, which was known as Thousand Bells Temple. And during the course of the time, the sea got extended and the temple got drowned inside. And even today, if people go to the shore, they can hear the sound of those thousand bells. When the waves move, those bells ring, it seems. And people who hear it, they will have an eternal bliss while on living on this earth. So one man heard about it. He sold all his property, took plenty of money and came to the shore. And he wanted to hear the sound. There was a coconut tree. He was sitting under the coconut tree's shade and trying to listen, listen, listen. He saw the waves are coming, roaring like anything. He heard the waves and he was telling his own mind, "You are wasting your life. You have wasted your money. Everything is wasted. Your life is wasted. What is the use? These are lies." In the evening hours, when he is disappointed, when he goes to the village, once again, he used to hear people talking about the thousand bells. When he heard, once again, he used to be courageous. Okay, now, next day I will go. Like that, he spent not 1 week, 1 month, 1 year. Then he came to know that this is a lie. Simply people have spoken. There is no temple here, there are no bells, because I have come here and witnessed for 1 year. So I'll go back. So now he is no more interested in listening to the bells or listening to anything. He is saying goodbye to everything. He said to the sea, "Goodbye, goodbye." He saw the waves, "Goodbye." Then he looked up the coconut tree. "Thank you, goodbye. You are giving me water when I was thirsty. You gave me shade when the heat was more. Thank you, goodbye, goodbye." When he moved from self to the nature, when he moved from self to get something, to give gratitude, thanks, something happened to him. He forgot, he moved away from self. And then he heard the bell, one bell, kring. Once again, he went into the same process, calming down himself to see things beyond, saying thanks to everything. "Thank you, thank you, thank you." Then suddenly he realized, "Lord, so many days I am here in this heat. You protected me. Thank you, Lord." When his heart went out of himself to the nature, to God, he heard the sound of the bells. Kinning, 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 kinning. Thousands of bells. Life is a gift of God. And that becomes a gift when we move beyond ourselves. Though we are of short breath, there is a breath in us that has breathed into us. And that's why we can continue to breath. My breath is short. As a young boy, I still remember I was studying 11th standard. So there was kabaddi competition between my village boys and other village boys. So I used to play kabaddi. Only that much I could. So by the time I have to cut back to the line, otherwise I am out. Once we come back, we realize, amma, again we have to get back. Our breath is very short. No. To the outside, external world, our breath is short. But when this short breath gets over, the source of breath supplies another breath, another breath, another breath, that we could continue to breathe on as much time he wishes. Blessed is the man who can see himself beyond himself. That's what Jesus said in Luke's Gospel, chapter 12. Easy to remember. You put opposite of 12 is verse 21. I give you. It is with those who store up treasures for themselves, but they are not rich towards God. They are not rich towards God. This is a parable the Lord spoke about a man who was blessed with plenty of crop. He saw the crop. He got stuck up with himself. He was telling, oh, this year I got plenty. I don't know what to do. So my house is small. I will break that and store it for many years. He was telling, enjoy, man. Eat, drink, make merry. God said, fool. Fool. Tonight, you are going to die. Who is going to take what you have stored? God has blessed you to be a blessing to the world. Genesis 12, 21. Genesis 12, 2. I have blessed you that you will be a blessing to the whole humanity. Through you, the whole humanity will be blessed. Genesis 12, 2. The two has to be in connection with the one. 12, 2. Yes. I have blessed you that you will be a blessing for many. This man had plenty of crop. God has blessed him. Because there are so many people in the world without food, that God wanted him to be a generous man. Because the joy comes in giving. God blesses us that we may become a joyful being. Joy comes in giving. Happiness comes in having for oneself. Man tries to have things, but God wants us to become To have or to be is the decision of one's soul. Many get stuck up with what they have. They don't move that they are called to be. To be, to belong to Him. To be with Him. That I can be with myself, I can be with everybody. This man got very good riches. But alas, what he received from God, he never saw. Like the third man who said, when I breathed, though this breath stop, I saw another breath is coming immediately. Another breath is coming. I know there is a source of breath. From that source, I am breathing. Today I am breathing because there is a source to which I belong to. When this breath is short, my source continues to give its breath. When people are not rich in the Lord, they get stuck up with themselves and they try to be rich in themselves. Today, God comes to teach us. When Adam and Eve, they received the breath from God in Genesis. First three chapters we read, they did not recognize the breath of God in them, the life of God in them, the one who shaped them, neither Adam nor Eve. How one from the bone, God could breathe and bring, make her a beautiful woman. She forgot and he forgot. When they sinned, the man became so angry. The same man who said, she is the bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. Now she is my joy. Now, what happened to that joy? When little problem came, why are you sad? Why did you do this? Not me. That lady you gave headache. Because of her, my life became miserable. Nobody can make your life miserable. Your life will become miserable the moment you get stuck up with yourself. The moment you don't realize that you are part of the divine. You have breath because you have a source of breath. He breathes into you so you could breathe. If he stops his breath, giving breath to you, you are no more. I am because he is. I am because we are. I am to give myself to wherever I am. He is the source of life. He is the source of salvation. In darkness, he brings light. In problem, he brings relief. In death, he gives life. And today, I am receiving his breath to carry his mission to bring light to darkness. To bring relief to those who are in struggle, to release the captives, and to bring hope to the hopeless humanity. I am sent by the Lord for the Lord.